Hello students, today we will discuss topic food obtained from animals from the chapter 1. So food obtained from animals, you are aware of this one, that what are the foods that we obtain from animals. The foods are milk, honey, meat, eggs. These are the foods that basically we obtain from an animal. We use milk of buffaloes, cows and goat. Mainly the milks of buffaloes and cows are used by us. And different region people use different animals' milk. Like people living in Himalaya region use milk of yaks. And people who live in desert areas, they use the milk of camel. Okay? Sip milk is also used by the people for drinking. So what is there inside the milk? If you say what is there in the milk that makes it so important for us to drink or use it in different items? So milk contains especially sugar. It contains sugar, fats is there, protein is there, vitamins and minerals are there. It is also known as complete food. Remember that milk is also known as complete food. If you've seen a small baby, it is not able to eat anything. It just takes the milk of the mother. And we eat so many things to keep us fit, but just merely drinking the milk keeps a child fit. Okay, so that's why we say milk is the complete food. So several food products like paneer, cream, butter, ghee and cheese and curd are made from milk only. These all items are made from milk. Now you see, milk from cows and other animals can have disease causing germs. To make it germ free, we have to pasteurize it. What is pasteurization? Pasteurization is a process in which the milk is heated to a specific temperature, that means to a fixed temperature. There is a fixed temperature up to which the milk is heated, and then it is cooled immediately. When this is done, the milk is heated up to a specific temperature and cooled immediately, it kills the germs present in the milk. This method of preserving milk was actually discovered by Louis Pasteur. Therefore, this method is known as pasteurization. Now, let us see about honey. What is actually honey? Honey is actually collected by bees from flower. Actually, what they do, these bees collect the nectar of the flower and store in the honeycombs. Honey is a natural sweetener. Okay? Human beings collect this honey and use it as a food. Okay, we use it as a fuse. It is rich in sugar and has many useful minerals in it. And also it is used as a medicine, or in the medicinal products it is used. Okay, so let us see more about honey. So the taste of honey depends on the flowers. On the flowers from which the bee has collected nectar. Okay, if suppose the flower nectar is bitter in taste, then the honey that will be collected in honeycombs will be bitter in taste. Okay, if it is collected from a flower which is whose nectar is sweet, definitely the honey present in the honeycomb will also be sweet. Okay. So let us move on to the meat and eggs. So meat and eggs. Meat actually we get from goat's chicken. And we use fish also as a food. Remember that. People eat eggs of hens and ducks. Okay. We especially eat eggs of hens and ducks. But there is some places like ostrich. The egg of the ostrich is also eaten by the people where ostrich is found. Means it is not that we are not limited to only hens and ducks. There are many birds who gives eggs, and the eggs can be eaten. So sea animals like prawns, squids and crabs are also used as food. So sea animals also, we use them as a food. And a food made from animals products are rich in proteins. Remember that, especially the food that we get from animals are rich in proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Okay, they do not contain any fiber, so too much of eating meat is also not healthy since it does not contain fiber, and as a result to clear our intestine will be a little difficult. Therefore we should also include green vegetables, fruits, cereals in our food. So this is all for today. Tomorrow we'll discuss another topic. Please revise at home whatever you've learned from here.